There's the excitement, the energy, the fans.
I'm getting tingly.
Don't ask questions. Don't pry. Be patient and remember that even though they may not seem to want affection, they need it now.
Don't think you can pull this on me.
Does this seem reasonable to you?
Look who's here.
This is going to be one of those days.
It's going to be really classy. It's going to be really fantastic. It's going to be you.
Let's do it.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to NSS. This is the Reynolds Report. The holidays are going to be awesome at the Dillon household this year with little Jacob and his siblings, hopefully getting enough PlayStation 5 systems that they don't need to even share, since their dad just came into a pretty massive windfall. Bob Dylan just sold off his entire music catalog to Universal Music Publishing Group. Reports are the deal was valued at $300 million. No specific terms of the deal have been announced, but it covers more than 600 songs, from the famous good ones to the famous bad ones, and is probably all about securing control of Dylan's music for streaming concerns. Fans of Letterkenny will get a holiday treat from Hulu this year. The comedy's ninth season is set to drop Saturday, December 26th.
Your pal ran into your old flame the other day.
Who?
Angie.
Who?
You.
Who?
She's acting different.
How's she acting different?
I don't think you want to know how she's acting different.
Wait. Now, was she acting different like I think she was acting different?
She was acting different exactly like you think she was acting different.
Oh, cripes. So she was acting different just like...
She was acting different like somebody who's gone traveling for the first time and then come home and is acting different.
Is there anything worse?
Stillborn puppies and nothing else.
This might have been the worst case I've ever seen.
So she's speaking with a bit of an accent then, Derry. She came home speaking with a wee bit of an accent then.
How's it now? Not every statement ends like it's a question then, Derry. Everything she says is like it's a fucking question, and innit?
Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
She using words like cheeky and bugger. Why, you cheeky bugger then, Derry.
Oi, Derry, you cheeky bugger. I haven't seen you in a bloody minute, have I? Haven't I?
Has she gone mad?
Is she knackered? Do you know what I mean?
Has she saying things to you like, cheers, ring me, yeah.
No, she did not say ring you.
Do you know what I mean?
Are you bothered?
Well, I'm not bothered.
Are you?
In it.
Do you?
Now I.
Do we?
Do you know what I mean?
So she watches TV on the telly then, yeah?
Yeah. And her apartment is now referred to as her flat, yeah?
And instead of waiting in line, she's waiting in the queue now, yeah? She's waiting in the queue for the tube now, yeah?
She's waiting in the queue for the pub now, yeah?
Waiting in the queue at the pub for a pint then, yeah?
Do you know what I mean?
Now, has she done Ibiza?
Yeah, Derry, has she done Ibiza?
Or Ibiza?
Has she done Barcelona?
Yeah, Derry, has she done Barcelona?
Barcelona?
Barcelona. Do you know what I mean?
Has she done Budapest?
Yeah, Derry, has she done Schlanka? Is she schlanken?
Has she done Melbourne? Not Melbourne, because it's pronounced Melbourne.
Melbourne.
Do you know what I mean?
And she only watches foreign features now, yeah?
It's like, did she stay off a beaten path or did she go to where it's touristy, right? Because you don't want to go to where it's too touristy. Do you know what?
All she's done is hostels and backpacks and kiwis.
The BBC.
It was like she photographed in like a cage with like a sedated tiger, innit?
I've written a bloody travel blog, haven't I?
The BBC 3.
And it's like, does she get a little schlog, get a little fex, so she's a little fex?
It's like there is comedy and then there is British comedy, you fucking bellend.
It's like them Yanks sew the Canadian flags up on their backpacks. What, when they go backpacking? Because you know everyone loves them Canadians, yeah?
I've unrolled me cigarettes, haven't I?
Pull your finger out of your ass.
And now Morgan Freeman as your local mall Santa.
Ho, ho, ho. Now tell Santa what you want, young man. Oh, wait a minute now. Ooh, damn. Is that your mama? Well, come on over here, darling. Well, Santa's got two laps. Mm-hmm. Well, what would you like for Christmas? I'm not talking to you, you stupid kid. Matter of fact, you know what? Take this dollar and get yourself an Orange Julius while Santa here finds out if mommy's been naughty. Wait, what? That's your daddy coming up? Oh, all right, that's it. Get off Santa's lap. On your way. There you go. That's it. On your way, you two. Get out. Go on. And give me back my dollar, you little turd.
That's Morgan Freeman as your local mall Santa.
A source says Joe Biden has chosen his Secretary of Defense. That's great. I'm still waiting for the call to be Biden's Secretary of Netflix. New study says long-term use of aspirin dramatically cuts the risk of dying from a wide array of cancers. That's great, but I'm still waiting for the good news from a long-term cheesecake study. With just over 2 weeks to go, 8 in 10 guys say they're starting to panic over the wives' Christmas gifts. Pro tip for you fellas, no matter what the salesman at Ace Hardware says, a diamond necklace is always preferable to a diamond drill bit. NBC announced it will continue their tradition of airing It's a Wonderful Life on Christmas Eve. Every year, Americans gather to watch it on television. These Americans are called people that don't have Netflix. Time for Nobody Gives a F***. Mariah Carey has launched her own cookie brand. So essentially, you can get fat while the lady sings. Hey, Nick Cannon, nobody gives a F***. Miley Cyrus has posed topless for Rolling Stone magazine, which is too bad, because like you, I was kind of hoping she was going to use the opportunity as a forum to share her idea on a workable strategy for creating peace between Israel and Palestine. Hey, Miley, nobody gives a f***. And a new study claims that men with beer bellies are statistically more likely to have weaker bones. That may be so, but they're also likely to have killer Super Bowl parties. So take the good with the bad. Hey, irrelevant studies. Nobody gives a f***. Thanks, everybody. We have a new episode of the Reynolds Report for you every weekday. Be sure to check out NSS Live, starring Frank D'Angelo, Tuesdays and Thursdays for NSS Live.